Hi, everyone. I wanted to share with you a tool that can be used to download and interact with MBARI's Video Annotation and Reference System, or VARS, data, which can be used for your projects. But before I describe the query tool, I'd like to give you more insight into VARS. So first off, VARS was developed to facilitate the creation, storage, and retrieval of video annotation records from footage recorded by our deep diving vehicles. 30 years ago, when we first started doing all this, all video data were recorded to tape while the vehicle and research vessel were at sea conducting research expeditions. And after the expedition was over and the ship returned to shore, the tapes would be taken to the video lab where experts would watch and annotate footage, providing vital information about what was in the recorded footage and when we observed all of it. All of these observations or annotations are also synchronized with vehicle sensor data that includes temperature, connectivity, depth, dissolved oxygen, and also latitude and longitude of the observation that provides contextual information about the observation. And more recently, we have switched to digital data and viewing tapes are now no longer necessary. But you can imagine that over the years of doing this, experts in the video lab have made more than 7 million annotations of more than 4,000 concepts and have collected more than 500,000 frame grabs. And all of this information is stored within the VARS database. And so while the Deep Sea Guide, which I described in another video, is a web-based method for you to explore the VARS data, the VARS query tool provides an application portal to download and interact with data directly. With more than, again, 7 million human observations or annotations and 4,000 concepts that include, you know, species, geologic features, or equipment in the VARS database, I mean, that's a lot of data to be playing with. So to get started, you will want to go to the VARS query 0.14 application download page on GitHub. And you can download the package that works for your system. So in my case, I have a Mac, so I'm going to download the DMG. If you have a PC or use Windows, you want to download the MSI file. And so once you start the download, you can then install the application. So for my Mac, I'm using, I just drag and drop the VARS query icon into the applications folder. So this is the VARS query tool page, and let me orient you to the application. So on the bottom, you see two buttons, add search term and remove all. And in the upper left-hand corner here, you can click the three horizontal bars and find options for going back to the homepage, refining the search or customizing your search. We will get back to these later, but let's go to the home section to return to the search page. And by clicking add search term, this will bring you to a page where you can either type in your concept name or apply filters. As always, I'm really interested in the giant larvation Bathycordius, so I'm going to type that in here. Oh, and remove the asterisk. So you'll see once you enter in a field of the field, your concept will return a list of concepts that might match what you're typing. This is very similar to what's done in the Deep Sea Guide. And like the Deep Sea Guide, these terms come from the VARS concept tree, which I showed you in the Deep Sea video. Mm-hmm. You need to click on one of these concepts in order to add them to your search. So I'm going to click on Bathycordius. You also notice below it, and recall that Bathycordius is the genus of giant larvations we find in Monterey Bay. And you can see four other concepts that are either parents, siblings, children, or descendants. So if you use the term Bathycordius, you can extend the search to concepts that are either parents, so one step higher in the concept tree, siblings, which is at the same height in the concept tree, children, so that includes things that are one step lower in the concept tree, or descendants, which includes all steps lower in the concept tree. And so, for example, if I select descendants, this includes the four other terms that you saw along with Bathycordius in the concept tree. So what this does, it will actually yield more results in your search, but just be aware of what these different terms actually mean. So I'm going to apply my search here, and then you'll notice that my search has been added to this VARS query homepage. So you can also filter your search by a number of other terms. So you go to that top left menu and hit refine search. And you can, you know, use these filters that include things like the association, the dive, information about the position, so the latitude and longitude or the depth. Also video information, if that's valuable to you, And also physical data, which I think will be of interest to this group. Observation, image, and other or additional information. So you also notice as I was scrolling through this, that there are some of these boxes that are already checked. So for example, you know, concept named or index time code. And what that means is that that field or that portion of data within the metadata will then be returned as part of your original search. And so for example, if you want to return, you know, along with the concept and let's say images, you want to, you know, make sure you're returning latitude and longitude of the observation, but also let's say you want to return light transmission data, the dissolved oxygen, the pressure, salinity, as well as the temperature of these observations. And remember that the video data or the image data are synchronized to the environmental data or the sensors that are on the remotely operated vehicle. And so we can select these filters and then display this information once we conduct our search. So now going back to the home page, and we've already made these changes to the filters, all you have to do is hit that button, the looking glass button, and then a window will pop up to show you that a query is actually running, and it will also tell you what the elapsed time of the query is. And so depending on the search term you used or whether you have descendants or children or parents, you know, the duration of the search can be, you know, of different lengths. And so keep that in mind. And, you know, this can vary anywhere from a couple seconds to up to several minutes. So after your VARS query search is over, it will return a new dialog box. And then what you'll get is basically a table of information where every single row corresponds to a single observation that matches your search terms. And so the first column is associations, which is really, you know, additional notes that might accompany an individual observation. The next column is concept, followed by depth. So what depth was that observation actually made? And then next is it's accompanied with a URL. So if you copied and pasted that URL into a web browser, that would give you an image or a frame grab that corresponds to that observation. Just wanted to point out though, that not all observations have an associated frame grab. Additional columns include, you know, time code, the latitude and the longitude of the observation, as well as, you know, light transmission data, the oxygen, pressure, salinity, temperature of the observation, right? Because we have the data and the sensors that are on the vehicle during this observation that's synchronized to the video. And then finally, you'll have a video sequence name, as well as some other codes, which I don't think is very important here, but the video sequence name will tell you what vehicle was used, as well as what number of dive did the observation occur on. So for instance, the first thing in this table, Ventana 3827, is a video that was taken by ROV Ventana on its 3827th dive. And so once you have this information, you can see these three different buttons up here, and you can select them, you know, either press save to save a text file, that you can then import into your favorite, you know, your favorite tool. You can also save a KML file, which is really an input file that you can put into, let's say, Google Earth and map the different observations. So where in, you know, where in the ocean did those observations occur? And then finally, you can save all of the frame grabs. And basically here you have to either create a directory or specify location where you want those images to be saved. And so if there are annotations that have or observations that have frame grabs, those frame grabs will be saved in that location. And so what's really incredible is once you have all this information, you can, these data outputs, you can then import them into your favorite data analysis tool or application. And that can be Excel, MATLAB, Python, or R, just pick one. And then really be able to look very closely and carefully at what the data are showing. So hopefully this was helpful, and good luck.